Hello everyone, this is Erik, the Asian movie enthusiast, and this is my review of Journey to the West, Conquering the Demons, which is a China-Hong Kong co-production from 2013 that is kind of a loose comedic reinterpretation of the novel Journey to the West, which is widely considered and recognized as a great classic novel of Chinese literature. Now, there have actually been dozens of film adaptations that have already been made, going all the way back to The Cave of the Silken Web back in 1927. So I've only seen a small handful of these films, which include Cave of the Silken Web, the 1967 version, A Chinese Odyssey from 1995, A Chinese Tall Story from 2005, and the two recent Monkey King films that came out in 2014 and 2016, the second of which I reviewed in a separate video on my channel, so check that out if you want. So how does Conquering the Demons compare to those films? Well, I would say that it's the best of this franchise that I've seen so far. Now, the story of this one takes place before our protagonist, named Tang, got his disciples and embarked on the journey to the West. So the movie begins in a riverside village that's being terrorized by a mysterious underwater creature. So a Taoist priest comes in and screws things up. So our protagonist steps in and resolves matters with the help of a beautiful demon hunter that just so happened to be in the area. After that series of events, this man continues to become entangled with the woman as they attempt to fight off a vicious pig demon who proves particularly difficult to kill. So the first thing that kind of hits you about Conquering the Demons right from the start is its infectious energy and brisk tempo. This hits the ground running, and before you know it, the first hour is gone. I mean, heck, even within the opening half hour, we get two very lengthy and entertaining human versus demon animal battles with some really creative action choreography in there. And you could tell it that they put a lot of thought into these fights. You know, there are certain things that you'll likely never see in a movie, you know what I mean, at least before this one. It uses positioning, mystical charms, deception, and blunt force in a huge variety of ways. It creates so much momentum, like, out of the gate, that for the most part, that momentum is sustained throughout the end of the film. So that makes this movie very easy and breezy to sit through. Not a huge surprise, given the director here, who is Stephen Chow. I've seen a ton of this man's previous work, both as a director and an actor, and every single one of the films that Chow directed, I think, is at least worth watching. He only has about 10 directing credits on IMDb, so it's a fairly small filmography that you could crank through fairly easily. And even his least interesting directed film, which I think is CJ7 from 2008, is still at least, you know, moderately amusing. It's kind of a family-friendly type kiddie film, I think, from what I remember. His acting nods will take a lot longer to get through, though. He has 70 acting credits on IMDb, despite the fact that he's only been in two movies as an actor over the past, like, 12 years. So the vast majority of his acting filmography was from the 90s and late 80s. But still, there's a lot of fun stuff in there to check out. A lot of times, I think he might have had some influence creatively to his films, even as an actor, especially after he got popular. So a lot of his films have a very nice comedic aspect to them. Now, Chow directs Conquering the Demons, but he does not act in it. Nevertheless, he's a very experienced filmmaker. You know, with all those credits behind him, he's operated in the realm of, like, crazy comedy, action, fantasy flicks for decades now. And that experience definitely it benefits Conquering the Demons because it helps to balance all of those crazy, weird tonal shifts and shifting between genres in the film. It helps keep it all together. He does a good job of that. This is really kind of like an action, comedy, horror, romance, fantasy film, if that makes sense. And it actually works throwing all those things together. Although I would say that the relationship between our two protagonists, I think, feels more kind of like a friendship rather than a romance. So there's a few brief dramatic moments near the end that don't really work as well as they could have, because, I don't know, I didn't really feel like they had that many sparks throughout the film. I felt like It felt like this guy was in the friend zone most of the time, even though this girl actively hits on him a few times as well. So I don't know, maybe I'm wrong on that, but I felt like they could have, on his part, he could have been acted a little bit more interested in her throughout the film to kind of help that chemistry a bit. But outside of those few like non-optimal dramatic moments down the stretch, the only other criticism that kind of pops out is the CGI quality here, which is cartoonish. If you're familiar with some of Chow's more recent films, you know, like Kung Fu Hustle or Shaolin Soccer, you'll kind of know what to expect. Although, it's probably, the special effects are probably better than those films, but it still does look a bit fake at times, you know? But as I always say, I'm a big fan of Clash of the Titans, that flick from the early 80s, so I'm very forgiving of outdated or not-so-good special effects, as long as the stuff around it works well, and I think that's the case here. A few more positives I want to point out is the humor, which is very funny. Shu Qi's performance, which is fantastic. She's really good in this. And the portrayal of the Monkey King himself. He's not a very likable character in this when he pops up during the second half. But he is actually rather menacing, which I kind of liked. He's kind of an angry, nasty-looking dude. I actually remember reading somewhere when this movie came out that in China, when the families took their kids to see this movie, some of the kids ran out, or didn't run out, but they were scared to the point of crying. That's good. Toughen them up a little bit, right? So most fortunately, Journey to the West, Conquering the Demons is widely available on both DVD and Blu-ray. So I definitely recommend you check this one out. It's a little bit different. Kind of an old, more old-school Hong Kongish type flick. And as always, we will see you next time.